Hello friends, myself Professor S.P. Mankani, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss governing of Pelton Turbine. So learning outcomes of this, students will be able to understand the governing of Pelton Turbine. So what is the governing of turbine? The governing of turbine is defined as the operations by which the speed of the turbine is kept constant under all conditions of working. It is done automatically by means of governor, which regulates the rate of flow through the turbine according to changing load conditions on the turbine. Before going to the actually governor, we are going to study a bit on the layout of hydroelectric power plant. So this part is totally related with as a civil engineering, and whatever the storage water is there, this head we are going to be considering it as a gross head, and the water is flowing through this penstock, and that it comes to the through the nozzle. Then nozzle hits to this particular as a runner. So in the runner blade, whenever it hits, it starts rotation. So now our importance of this governor is governing of this particular as a system. So here this particular shaft is coupled to the governor. We are going to study from this particular shaft output to the next to the governor. We are not related with that this particular discussion as this total part. So here governing of Pelton turbine. So I am going to discuss the first as related with the total all components. Then we will come back to the working condition of governor of Pelton turbine. So here this is a oil sump, and this one is a oil pump which is pumping the oil through this particularly to the piston rod of controlling valve and relay of control valve. So oil is coming to the relay of the control valve, and this is particularly as a piston rod of relay cylinder. So here this particularly we are going to be controlling this water flow, this one. So here the previous discussion of hydroelectric power plant, whatever the output is coming through the shaft of the Pelton turbine, that shaft is coupled to this particular as this shaft, so to turbine main shaft. So here only the difficulties are going to arise as, so here this part is coupled with the turbine shaft and this part is coupled with the governor. So here we have to consider this one working and this one working now. So in this particularly, we are going to discuss as whenever there is a power consumption is reduces, power consumption reduces on the load center. So that time suddenly that affects on the generator. So generator, it starts at the highest speed. Means whenever there is a reduction in the load on the power stations, means what that is directly affecting to the generator, and generator is coupled with the turbine, and turbine is coupled to this particularly through the shaft to the governor. So here one thing we have to understand in this particular as, whenever there is a load comes on the generator, so that time it reacts to the turbine shaft. So now we are going to study this particularly the related with as a nozzle, how we exactly it controls to the governor. So here whenever there is a reduction of the load, means every day the load requirement on the city is not same. Even it is in the seasonal also, it is not same. We are going to be getting as a fluctuation of the load every time. So here, whatever that reduction of the load is going to be taken place, so that is going to be affecting this particularly as a turbine. So now we are considering the first case as the load is reduced. Means the requirement of the load is less, and because of that the generator is getting it as a lesser load, and because of that it is at a highest speed. So that time whenever the speed of the generator is going to be increased, so because of that is the particularly as a speed of the turbine is also going to be increased. When the speed of the turbine is going to be increased, so that time this particularly flywheel, flyballs which is connected here, these flyballs are going to be moving in the upward direction because of centrifugal force which is acting on this one. And when these balls are moving in the upward direction, that time this sleeve, whatever it is connected with this one, this sleeve is also going to be moving in the upward direction. When the sleeve is moving in the upward direction, that time this lever is connected to the sleeve, and the lever is going to be operated, and this lever is also going to be shifted in the upward direction. When the lever is shifted in the upward direction, because of this fulcrum, and this is going to be affecting in the downward direction. So means this is moving in the upward direction and this is coming in the downward direction. So because of moment of the this particularly piston rod, so this is coming in the downward direction. So that is the reason this particular piston is coming in the downward direction. So whatever the diagram I am representing here, this diagram is at the normal condition. Normal condition is nothing but a speed, normal speed we are going to be working it. So this position I am representing here as a normal condition figure. So now because of the moment of this particularly sleeve in the upward direction and the moment of this lever in the upward direction and this particularly the piston rod is coming in the downward direction. So this piston is closing this V1 wall. Piston is closing this V1 wall. At the same time, this is coming in the downward direction and V2 is going to be operating. And here, this particularly the oil pump which is given the oil at a higher pressure. So this high pressure oil moves through this particularly pipe. And that pipe, that oil is going to be acting on the surface, which is forcing on the surface A. And because of that, it is forcing it in the forward direction. So whenever it is forcing it in the forward direction, and here this whatever the area available for this nozzle, so is going to be reduced. When the area is going to be reduced, the flow rate is going to be controlled. When the area is going to be reduced, the flow rate is going to be controlled. And when the flow rate is going to be controlled, and because of that one, the speed of the turbine is going to be reduced. When the speed of the turbine is going to be reduced, so that time the speed of the generator which is coupled to this turbine is also going to be reduced. And the speed of the generator is going to be reduced, at the same time power development, power whatever production is going to be reduced. So means in this particular lens, whenever the requirement of the power is going to be reduced, so that time whatever the load is on the generator is going to be reduced, and because of that speed of the turbine is increased, and now our intention is to control the speed of the turbine. So now by this moment, once again I will repeat from this particularly, so sleeve is moving in the upward direction because of the centrifugal flows which is acting on the fly balls, and then this lever is going to be in the upward direction, and by that this rod is coming in the downward direction, this V1 wall is closed, and at the same time V2 wall is opened, and the oil is coming through this particularly in this particularly cylinder, and it is acting a force on this particular A surface, and this is moving in the forward direction. Okay, now so whenever it is moving in the forward direction, it is closes the flow rate. It closes the flow rate. By that we are going to be controlling the speed of the turbine. So at the same time, supposed to be the load is going to be increased on the generator, means the requirement of the load is going to be increased. So that time when the load is going to be increased on the generator, that time the speed of the generator is going to be reduced, and the speed of the generator is going to be reduced, then automatically that load comes on the turbine. Turbine speed is also going to be reduced. When the turbine speed is going to be reduced, these fly balls are coming in the downward direction, and because of that sleeve is acting, and here this particular sleeve is coming in the downward direction, at the same time lever is operating in the downward direction. At the same time, this particularly V1, so in the previous case that it is coming in the downward direction, and now the V1 it is going to be moving in the upward direction. When it is moving in the upward direction, the high pressure oil is going to be flowing through this particular pipe, and it comes through this way, and the force is going to be acting on the surface of a B. When the acting on the surface of the B, it is going to be pushing it in the backward direction. At the same time, this wall is, this nozzle is going to be opening, and when the opening of the nozzle is going to be more, at the same time water flow rate is going to be increased. When the water flow rate is going to be increased, that time the turbine speed is also going to be increased. When the turbine speed is going to be increased, at the same time which is coupled to the generator or alternator, both are going to be at a higher speed. Because the load is increased, it tries to give a flow rate, more flow rate, then we are going to be getting as a higher power. The same operation we are going to be observing with the animation effect in the next slide. So once again, before conclusion of this particular slide, so this whatever the figure is shown, this total figure is at a normal condition. Normal condition is at a constant speed. Constant speed is a normal speed we are going to be considering it. So now we are going with the next slide. So what are the types of the governors? So based on the source of controlling force, the governors can be classified into two types: centrifugal governors and inertia governors. We are now discuss the detail as a centrifugal governors. So now just you can observe a minute the governing of Pelton turbine. Just you can observe the operations, how the flow rate is going to be taken place, and it is pushing backside. Only one operation has shown in this particular diagram, just for reference purpose. Thank you.